Hello and welcome to this tutorial on creating regular polygon arenas from circles. Here we will go through two approaches, one using the radius of the incircle and the other one using the radius of the circumcircle. And how do we set up everything? We add our behavior to a game object that is placed in the center. We tell how many edges we want the arena to have. We give the reference to the edge object that we will be using for the arena, as well as calculating the radius of the circle that we will be using on creating new arenas. There are two circles that we will be using to create polygon arenas. One called incircle, which is inside the polygon, passing through the midpoints of the edges. And the other one is called circumcircle, which is outside the polygons, passing through all vertices of the polygons. Here in the screen we have examples of both, with polygons with edge count 3, 5 and 20. Left ones are created with an incircle approach and right ones are created with a circumcircle approach. Using incircle, we draw the polygons outside the circle and the lower the edge count, wider the area of the arena. This holds reversely for circumcircles. Polygons are drawn inside the circle area and the area gets smaller with lower the edge count. In both cases, higher the edge count, the polygon is closer to look like a circle itself. I have been using this approach in my thesis to create spawning sources towards the center and used edges as look targets to interact with the sources. I find using a circumcircle and increasing or decreasing the edge count with level progression a possible usage. All in all, if you don't want to use a modeling software and move each edge by yourself for your polygon arena, you can use this. Before starting the code walkthrough, let's have one more look at our behavior. The owner of the behavior is the center of any of the circles. It gets an edge count. Reference the edge object, the game object that is the edges of the polygon to be created, and the determiner of the radius of the chosen circle approach to create the polygon. Lastly, it gets a creation approach that will be used to create the polygon arena. When we hit run, the polygons are created with separate edge objects for each edge and stored under their representative parent transforms. One last thing. The implementations on this script are done by following the equations on this page, which will be linked in the descriptions. Here is their representation of circumcircle, incircle, R polygon, radius of incircle Ri, radius of circumcircle Rc, edge length and angle step theta. And here is the proposed transformations between incircle radius, circumcircle radius and edge length. We will be using these in our implementation. Now we are ready to start the code walkthrough. We start with an enum declaration called ArenaCreation mode. It has two values it can take, from incircle or from circumcircle, for initiating polygon ArenaCreation respecting the approach. And now ArenaCreator. Here we have three public variables which are filled from the editor. ArenaCreation approach decides circle to be used to create a polygon. Edge object will be the edge for the arena as well as be used for calculating the radius of the circle that we will be using on creating new arenas. Lastly, edge count is the number of edges the polygon arena will have. Angle step is the angle value of each pi of the divided circle. Using this, we will be spawning the new edges, rotating around the center. Lastly, edge appear duration is the duration passes after each edge added to our polygon to give their appearance and animated effect. We are ready to make the call to create a polygon arena. For this tutorial, I will be creating the arena from a coroutine so that each edge appears one by one. You can transform this call to a normal function call and get your polygon arena instantly by getting rid of coroutine necessities and transform create arena function to a normal function. Okay, continuing on from where I left off. We create a polygon arena by calling create arena function. This function uses all the information from the class, so no variables. If this will be used from outside, it should take these values as variables or check whether the values are filled and legit. And now creating the arena. To create the arena, first we create the parent transform to hold the child edge transforms. Creating the object using new game object, the object is at the center of the world space. We need it at the center of the polygon. So we are moving it to where the center object is. Parent object is used to tidy up the hierarchy and as a preliminary work for creating this arena returning the parent transform in possible iterations. Angle step is calculated by dividing 360 to edge count and will be used to rotate edge object with each spawn. Edge length will be set by our chosen polygon arena creation approach and be used to scale the edges. Initial radius is the distance between the edge object and the center of the polygon, in other words, position of owner of this behavior. We will use this value as the initial radius of chosen approach. If we are using circumcircle approach, then it is the radius of circumcircle, or if we are using incircle approach, it is the radius of incircle. For the approaches, I will be using the equations on the webpage I mentioned earlier, specifically the equations with pi divided by edge count. We could also use angle step divided by 2, but that will be in degrees, and trigonometric functions take the angle value in radians, and I didn't want to add a transformation step. That's why I went with matf pi divided by edge count, which equals angle step divided by 2. That much background info is enough. Now I have created a similar graphic for showing the incircle and the circumcircle of a square. Here, ri is the radius of the incircle and rc is the radius of the circumcircle. You see the perpendicular distance between the center of the polygon to edges is ri, and we will be moving our edge object by ri in z direction for both approaches to give it a more systemized positioning. Starting with incircle approach, that is, if ArenaCreation approach equals from incircle. We are setting the value of radius of incircle, ri, to initial radius. Using ri and the equations, we calculate edge length to use later for scaling the edge objects. Lastly, we move the edge object by ri in z direction starting from center. The other approach is circumcircle approach. In this one, initial radius equals rc, radius of circumcircle. This time we need to calculate edge length and ri so that we could put the edge object in the correct place distance from the center, as it starts on the circumcircle. Ri is calculated from rc, and same with incircle, edge length calculated by ri, and the edge object placed ri away from center in z direction. With the chosen polygon creation approach, we set the position of the edge object and calculated the edge length. It is time for setting its rotation and scale. I had chosen the edges to look at the center using transform lookat to look at the owner of this behavior, so that in any scenarios they need to be moved or spanned, moving things they also look at center, and by using lookat we confirm the game object will not have any rotations in x and y axes as well. For instance, these edge objects had some random rotations and everything is corrected before creating new edges for the polygon. For the scaling part, we use the edge length calculated from ArenaCreation approaches. We scale the edge in x-axis, as the axis will be representing the edge length, since y-axis is aligned with both specified axes, and in z-axis, edge object is looking at the center. For the scaling, the scales of y and z-axis are left as the object's initial scales. If you would like, you can tweak these values. We set up the edge, position, rotation, and scale-wise. Now we will start creating the polygon arena. Since the edge object will be a part of the current arena parent, first we set the edge object as a child object to arena parent, using edge object's transform set parent function. Now we will create other edges in the polygon using the current edge object. Since we already have an edge, we start creating the edges from index 1 to edge count minus 1. Put it more simply, for each step we create a copy of the edge object using instantiate function, and rotate the edge object around the center, which is the position of the owner of this behavior, inverse step space, up axis by angle step, and wait edge appear duration so that we have an animated step there for each edge. The new edge creation process includes parentages in hierarchy. To have each instantiation work with our approach, we also provide the parent transform information in the instantiation step. We still could correct everything with these three lines of code, but a single line is enough for our aim and we are using that one. And while we are here, I want to remind you again, we are creating the polygons in x, z axes, and after the creation, you can either save the arena parent form code or in the editor, drag it to project files and have a new prefab containing the created polygon arena. With that point, this is the end of this tutorial. This was something I had created way before at the start of August, but I was concerned whether I could explain the approach well. Now it is here. I hope I did a good job. This was a challenge for me, and I really hope that this tutorial brought you something new that you can use in your projects. As always, if there was a point not clear, let me know in the comments down below. And if you like this video, please give it a like and subscribe for the future ones. I hope to see you in the next exploration, and bye bye.